minutes, honey, because you already know. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing my current favorite spring fragrances. Spring is in full effect here in Atlanta, and I am ready for it. As you can see with my beautiful dress today, I will link it down below. I just attended a baby shower for a friend, virtually of course, and I said, you know what, while I'm all dolled up, let me crank out a video for you guys. So today we're going to be talking about fragrance. I'm also going to be sharing 5 fragrances that are on my spring wish list, so look forward to a spring video next month. I've already started to amass some spring fragrances, so let's get right into it. Okay, so I'm gonna start in no particular order. Let's first start with what I'm wearing right now. I wore this scent to bed last night, and darling, I woke up smelling amazing. I am gonna be doing a video about nighttime or bedtime scents. Not the spicy, sexy, come hither ones, but scents that really smell nice at night, because I run hot. Like, I get as hot as a woman in menopause, and that is no shade to anyone in menopause because I'm feeling your pain. I run extremely hot. So with the warmth of my body, sometimes a fragrance can either smell better or worse. So I'm gonna be sharing one of those videos soon, but this scent that I am sharing with you today is what I'm wearing. This is Tom Ford's Soleil Neige. Now I'm gonna put the fragrance notes across the screen, but this smells like aquatic, bergamot, and white florals. There's a musky note to it. It smells very warm. Like, I always call this my winter sun goddess fragrance because it does smell very warm, but it smells like icy and fresh. And to me, this scent can be transitioned through all 4 seasons because it has that really fresh bergamot note, but it's also a little musky. This is my Kendra scent because my friend got this for me for Christmas. And so every time I wear it, I think of her, but it is very fresh and aquatic and a little bit warm, maybe even like a hint of spice, but just really different. This is the only Tom Ford fragrance that I own. You guys know I am really not big into Tom Ford, but this is just beautiful. It's a very like elevated, sophisticated, aquatic, fresh, everyday scent. It's beautiful. So I have it on today and I love it, love it, love it. This is a great fragrance that I think is a little underloved here on YouTube, but one of my favorites for spring for sure. Okay, next we have an older scent that I first shared with you guys during Vlogmas, I believe. You guys know the story. I went to my friend's house. He had this. He's like always sharing fragrances with me. He's told me about a few that he does not want me to share with you guys. I don't know how that's gonna work, but we'll see. But he had this on his fragrance stand and I tried it and fell in love. This is Amo's Ferragamo. Now, Amo Ferragamo to me is a floral bouquet in a garden with notes of orange. It smells like vanilla and orange, an orangicle, but in a very feminine, beautiful way. This I started wearing in December just because obviously I'm still quarantined. I only leave the house for appointments, meetings, and things that I need, like groceries or something like that. So I technically would wear this year round just because I'm in the house and I'm not going anywhere. And typically I go for a lighter type of scent when I'm in the house, but this is a traditional spring fragrance. Yeah, it's an orangicle in a garden, very light, very feminine without smelling juvenile. It's very, very beautiful. A really, really nice everyday light scent, very feminine. It's nothing like super sexy and come hither. It's just a light, floral, citrusy, yeah, beautiful scent. Very light and fresh. Love that. Okay, now we have a more affordable fragrance, and this is Zara's Apple Juice. If you guys have been watching my channel since about December-ish, I purchased this, I believe, in December during Vlogmas, but I didn't share this with you guys until January. And then again, this month when I did my Zara try-on haul, which was so much fun. By the way, thank you guys so much for the awesome feedback. But shout out to my girl, Chloe. I will link her channel down below. She is just everything, and she's becoming my go-to source for all things fashion. She put me onto this fragrance because she said that it smells amazing when mixed with Baccarat Rouge 540, which is my number one favorite fragrance of all time. She was right. Apple Juice to me is a fresh apple crisp scent with like floral notes in it. It's perfect for every day. It's perfect for wearing around the house. It's the perfect quarantine scent. It's great for running errands. It is just a beautiful scent. I imagine myself wearing this to the country club, playing a little tennis or whatever, even wearing it to the pool in the summertime. This is a beautiful, fresh, just nice everyday scent. It reminds me of spring. So thank you so much to my girl, Chloe. This is also a great scent for mixing because it smells like apple, floral notes, and maybe a little hint of citrus. It has like a tart note in it from the apple. This is a great mixing scent. Now, I have not delved too far into mixing my fragrance because I'm still a little afraid of that, but this definitely smells amazing with Baccarat Rouge 540, but on its own, it's just very fresh and bright and a little tart. Perfect for the springtime. And it's affordable. I believe this 3.3 or 3.4 ounce bottle is about $20 to $24, which is amazing. Okay, let's follow the more affordable one with probably the most expensive one that I'm sharing today. This is my probably favorite fragrance right now, and this is Louis Vuitton's Etrep Rêve. Once again, if you guys have seen any of my luxury videos since December, I hauled this in my luxury haul in January, and I will link that down below. I received this for Christmas. I have KB hot stamped on it. You're not going to be able to see it, but I'll insert a picture from Instagram where you might be able to see it a little more. This is a beautiful rose chocolate sweet sexy scent. Now, for me, this is like an everyday scent. Now, it's an everyday sexy scent. So your man or your woman, guy, girl, whoever you are with, they are gonna love this on you because it's sweet, it's sexy, it has like a little bit of citrus in it. It's very floral. This is an amazing blind buy purchase. I actually purchased a sample before I put it on my Christmas list, but this is amazing. To me, it smells like rose and chocolate. It's very sweet. It is a little more strong than I thought it was upon initially spraying it, but men will love this. Women, whoever you're with, they're gonna love this because it's sweet, it's sexy, but it's also still light enough to me. This would be an amazing Mother's Day gift. It's just a beautiful floral, like sparkling rosy scent with chocolate gourmand notes. I love it. This just reminds me of an ultra chic feminine woman who just oozes sex appeal, and this is definitely one of my favorites. Okay, let's go to another more affordable fragrance. This is Alexandria Fragrances Fructus Virginis. And this scent is comparative to the Tom Ford's Lost Cherry, which I do not own. So Alexandria Fragrances actually gifted this to me, and I tried this out a few months back. I'll link that video down below. They have some amazing fragrances that are both inspired by higher priced fragrances and also original creations of the brand. But this to me smells like, this smells like a juicy, bursting, sweet, syrupy yet tart rose. Now, I have not smelled Tom Ford's Lost Cherry before. Because I just don't know how I feel about going to a mall right now and touching fragrances and smelling them and putting them up to my nose. So I have not tried it. So I cannot compare it to the original. But what I can say is that if you're looking for a juicy, syrupy, sweet, yummy, like seductive and sexy cherry fragrance, this is it. A lot of my ladies have said that this mixes really well with other fragrances. I have not tried it yet because you guys know I'm still a little wary about that. But for a beautiful, syrupy, tart cherry fragrance for spring, this is your go-to. I also love wearing this just around the house during the day. It's perfect. It's so feminine, but I'm interested to see how this would smell on a man, so I might have to try that out. Just a really gorgeous, syrupy cherry scent. Love that one. Okay, next we have an oldie but goodie. This is Diptyque's Eau Rose. I purchased this, no, actually I was gifted this fragrance from someone. It wasn't like gifted by Diptyque, but I received this fragrance probably 2 or so years ago. I went on a hunt for the perfect rose scent because rose is one of my favorite fragrance notes. But for me, because I run very hot and scents can get a little sour on me, a lot of roses smell like a little old lady, no shade, or they just smell way too sour. So Diptyque's Eau Rose is my favorite Secret Rose. It has a ton of different types of rose within the fragrance. It's a very tart, sweet, gentle rose. It smells very, very clean and fresh and floral. This is another great scent for wearing around the house, but it's also great for spring because it's a floral scent. And to me, spring is all about really nice, fresh floral scents and aquatic scents. I love this. I've loved other rose scents. I think Jo Malone has Red Roses scent. That smells like a little old lady on me. So if some rose scents tend to lean a little sour on you or don't smell the best, definitely check out Diptyque's O Rose. I don't hear too many people talk about Diptyque fragrances overall, but this is definitely one that I am currently obsessed with. It just smells very fresh and rosy. I love it. It's just a great all-around, nice, simple springtime fragrance. Okay, and the last fragrance that has been a staple for me this spring, but also year-round, because like Chanel is just a classic year-round, is Chanel's Coco Mademoiselle. Now, when I describe Chanel's Coco Mademoiselle, I always speak about my mother because she is like the epitome of a classically chic and sophisticated woman. This reminds me of my childhood because my mother used to wear the heck out of this when I was a child. It smells, I don't even know what the notes are. Maybe jasmine, maybe a bergamot note. It's like a spicy, citrus, classic, chic scent. This is what I would wear to work if I was going into the office right now. This is what I would wear to church if I were going into the sanctuary. This is a classically chic, citrus, sparkling, just very beautiful scent. I'll of course put the notes across the screen. This is just classic. This is beautiful. I put it in the spring category because I believe it has jasmine in here. It smells very citrusy and fresh, but it has a depth to it. If you have smelled any of the Chanel fragrances, they all kind of have a similar Chanel DNA, which is just strong and bold and classic and striking. So this is not going to be fresh and beautiful like a Diptyque O Rose or even a Louis Vuitton Etat Rave. This is definitely more robust and it's heavier, but it's also still light. If you want to go for something super classically chic this spring, this is what I'm going to be recommending. I love this. Like I said, it reminds me of my mother. I do think it's a little more mature, and when I say mature, I don't mean like, oh, you can only wear it if you're a senior citizen. I don't think many in their early 20s would appreciate this the way someone in their 30s and 40s on up would, because to me, Chanel DNA is very classic and strong. It's not a fruity, oh, I'm so coy. No, no, no. This is a fabulous, chic, and classic woman. It's still a light fragrance, but it's beautiful. So definitely, definitely one of my favorites. Okay, now let's talk what is on my spring fragrance wish list, because you guys know I have a very long list in my phone. So the first scent that I cannot wait to try is called Jimmy Choo I Want Choo. And shout out to my girl Roya. I will link her channel down below. She has talked about this fragrance so much and I cannot wait to try it. I am not a fan of Jimmy Choo fragrances. I have tried probably 5 of them. I like them, but I don't like them enough. But from the reviews that I'm seeing online and from my girl's experience, I really think I'll like this one. We have very similar likes in terms of fragrances, and she told me that I will love this, so I'm definitely going to try that one. I looked it up on Fragrantica, which I always do. It's my number one source for finding information, because before I purchase a fragrance, I like to do a bit of research, especially because I'm not leaving the house now to go touch and smell everything. So Fragrantica is amazing because it lists the fragrance notes, it lists history and background about the fragrance, and people also leave reviews, which is always important to me. Now, of course, not everybody is going to like or feel the same way about a fragrance, but I like to see what people think about a fragrance because it ties into my overall opinion. People have said that the Jimmy Choo fragrance is comparative to the Carolina Herrera Good Girl, or the one with the shoe. I'm not exactly sure what it's called, so I definitely want to pick that up. It's supposed to be a fresh and fruity, bold fragrance. Another one that is on my wish list is Charlotte Tilbury. And I don't know whose video I was watching. It might have been Roya's video. I'm not sure. But the Charlotte Tilbury fragrance is not one that... No, no, no. It wasn't her. It was AI the Great. And you guys know that is my girl. She spoke about this fragrance in a video maybe this past month. And I don't see too many women talk about this fragrance. I don't even see it available on too many websites. First of all, I am a Charlotte Tilbury lover. You guys know that. And so I, of course, have to try this fragrance out. I'm probably going to blindly purchase it. The bottle is beautiful. I want to say it's like a fruity type of fragrance. I've heard it can smell a bit mature, but like a good mature. So I'm definitely interested in that. My sis Severe told me about the Louis Vuitton. Now I don't know how to pronounce this. I'll put the name across the screen. H-E-U-R-E-S De Absence fragrance. Now in my mind, I'm feeling like this is going to be a very fresh fragrance because most of the Louis Vuitton fragrances that I have tried are very fresh, and most of the times any scent that my sis Severe loves, I appreciate as well. I'm probably going to look that one up on Fragrantica and see if that's one that I will like. Let's see what else. I don't want to give you guys too many of the ones on my wish list because I will be doing a video. I want to try Byredo La Tulipe. I believe my friend who I spoke about with the Amo Ferragamo, I believe he told me about that one. And like I said, there are certain people in my life, when they recommend a fragrance, I immediately know I'm going to love it because we like a similar scent profile. I actually don't own any Byredo fragrances. I tried them once in store with that friend maybe 3 years ago, and I don't remember which ones I liked. So I definitely want to try that one. And I heard that is a newer one, I believe. I might be confused, but I definitely want to try that. One that I definitely want to purchase is Maison Francis Kurkdjian's A La Rose L'Homme. Now that is one that I got a sample of last year when I was on my MFK craze and I was purchasing like 4 fragrances and losing my mind. I'm sure you guys remember. I got a sample of that one. You guys know I love a good rose scent, but that's a rose scent for him. And I don't own too many men's fragrances. I'm definitely not someone who just thinks, oh, I'm a woman, I have to only wear women's fragrances. Honey, I will rock a man's fragrance, especially because I love a good juxtaposed vibe. So if I'm wearing something super feminine, I will absolutely throw on a men's fragrance because I love juxtaposition. Juxtaposition to me is just so sexy. So the A La Rose for him is definitely more tart than the women's rose. So I really want to pick that one up. I'm trying not to because last year I went so hard on MFK and I just don't feel like I need any more right now, but I did say that I was gonna get that, and that's another beautiful rose that I like. To me, it does not smell masculine. I really, really like the way that one smells on me because I said my body runs more hot, so especially in the springtime when I am hot, it just gets so tart and beautiful on me, so I absolutely want to pick that one up. So I don't know if those were 5 fragrances, but those are the ones that I'm definitely interested for spring. So let me know which, come on Chloe. So those are the fragrances that I'm interested for spring and also my top picks for this spring. Let me know what you guys are loving down below. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. I am just so happy that it is spring. I mean, actually it feels more like summer here in Atlanta, but we're gonna stick with spring for now. Leave any comments or questions you guys may have down below. Bless you, Chloe Monster. Oh, let me show you guys Chloe. Come here, baby. Because you guys have been asking, come here, asking for videos with Chloe Monster. And since I'm not vlogging anymore, do I say hi? Do I say hi? Look, you see your friends? Well, at least she's not turning over her over my shoulder. That's rude, Muff. I figured I would show you guys a little Chloe Monster since I'm not vlogging anymore. So she is doing well, just thriving and living her very best, fabulous puppy life, being a baby. She's definitely my biggest baby. You see your friends? Everybody always asks about you. Oh, thank you. I guess that was a kiss for you guys. So thank you all so much for watching. I love you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.